Hello there, all my lovely jewelry makers. I'm Christina of CSL Designs, and in today's tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make this alternating pyramids wire weave that you can use for whatever you want to. So if you want to learn how to make it, then keep watching. So in this case, I'm going to be working with 5 lengths on my 1mm base wire, but you can really use however many you want to. It'll just make it wider or narrower. And the weaving wire is a 0.4mm, and I'm leaving this attached to the reel. So I have my weaving wire ready, and then I'm going to start with one of my lengths of base wires, and then I'm starting towards one end of the base wire and also the weaving wire, leaving a short little tail. And first of all, I just want to attach this weaving wire to the base wire. So I'm going to do that by simply wrapping it around once, like that. And then we want to start bringing in the other remaining base wires. So grab another one, place it above the first one, so it's the new top one, and then take your weaving wire, go over the top of both of them like that, and then down behind over the top again, so we have 2 wraps over the top of both of them right next to each other. Then we want to come up between the 2 and then push that down and bring in the next base wire, lay that as the new top one. Now go over the top of the top 2 base wires, so not the bottom one there. So we're kind of stepping up once, and then down behind, come up in the same place so we can go over the top of both again. So we have now 2 wraps around the top 2 base wires, then come up between those 2. Push that down, grab the next base wire, and then again we're stepping up again. So I'm going to go over the top of the top 2 base wires, come up in the same place to go over the top of the same 2. Once more, make sure each wrap is nice and tight. Come up between those 2, so between the top 2 here. And then again, use that to push that down, which also helps tighten up your wraps. And then I have 1 length of base wire left. Bring that in. Now obviously if you have more, you can just keep going until you use your last one. Over the top of those 2, open the same place so we can wrap around those 2 again. So now we've reached the top point basically. So this is kind of one half of the first triangle or pyramid, however you want to look at it. And we now need to step down again. So that means I'm going to bring the weaving wire down behind the wires and then basically step down once, which means coming up between the wires. So I have 2 on the bottom and 3 on the top, because that means I can then go over the top of these 2 base wires here. So I'm leaving a top one, and then there's 2 on the bottom in this case because I'm using 5. So we're basically just stepping down once, and then otherwise we need to do the same, come up between the same place there and wrap around those same 2 base wires. So we get the 2 wraps every single time. Now step down again. So this time in my case, it's down between the bottom 2 base wires, then wrap over the next 2, push it down, and then once more. So we get those 2 wraps, and then we just have 1 left, which is around the very bottom 2 base wires. So simply wrap around those twice, and then we have our first triangle or pyramid. Then we need to move on and make our next pyramid, but this next one needs to be in the opposite direction. So here we have the point going upwards. Now we need the next one for the point to go downwards. So I've got my weaving wire here behind the wires. Now instead of bringing it down like the other times, I'm going to bring it up towards the top, and then it's basically the same technique we're going to be doing in creating the pyramid, but obviously we're just kind of working in the opposite direction. So I'm going to start out by going around from the top now, over the top of the top 2 base wires, starting with that, and I'm just going straight up from where that first one ended. So I'm starting right above it, and then around those top 2 again, so over the top of them, and push them nice and tight, then come up between those 2, and then again push that down. I want to make sure that we don't wrap these 2 base wires and pull them too tight when we're doing these wraps we just did, because we need to make sure that our weaving wire can come all the way down between. And then we need to step down, because now doing the first half, we're stepping down instead of up. So I'm just going to go down 1 base wire. So we wrap over the top of the next 2, leaving out the top one there, and then the bottom 2 as well. Come up in the same place so we can wrap around both of them again, the exact same way as the other one. So 2 wraps around 2 base wires every time, and then come up between those 2 that we just wrapped, step down 1 base wire. If at any point you feel you can't quite get the wraps tight enough, you can always use your pliers to help push your wire into place, and then up in the same place to make that double wrap. Push them nice and tight, come up between the 2, and then we're down to the very bottom 2 base wires. We just want to wrap around those, which technically for this one here is going to be the point of the pyramid. So this is now the first half of this next one. So now we need to step in technically upwards again, but obviously it's kind of downwards if we're looking at the pyramid shape. So We just need to step up one base white stone, come behind three and go down between the bottom two. So we can wrap around those two twice, come up in the same place, down again. Now step up one base wire and coming up between the top two, and then just wrap over the top of the two base wires below where you're coming up. Repeat that by coming up in the same place and down, and then make your way all the way behind the base wires upwards so we can go over the top of the top two base wires and basically complete this pyramid, this upside down one, like that. And there we have the next one, separated from the other one, but obviously in the opposite direction as well. And then we basically just want to keep repeating this. So I'm going to take my weaving wire, instead of it coming upwards now, I'm going to bring it down, and then straight across from where we ended that pyramid, I'm going to start the next one, which is going to be the same as the first one. So you just want to start that by wrapping around the bottom two base wires twice, come up between the two, and then otherwise continue in the exact same way as I showed you first. Obviously now we don't need to add in the wires as we go, that's already done, but just move your way up to the point. That's the first half, make your way back down on the other half. That's your next pyramid, and just keep going like this, alternating from which direction you're making the pyramid from. And this is then how the final weave looks. It's a bit of an optical illusion almost, and you can of course use it for whatever you want to, and like I said, also use more or less wires. It's completely up to you. So I hope you enjoyed the tutorial for this wire weave. It's going to be part of the playlist I have for loads of tutorials for different wire weaves. I'm going to of course leave a link to that in the description box down below. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching this one, and I'll see you in the next one.